Hi everyone, this is Naina from the Department of English. So today we will be looking at the second part of active voice and passive voice lesson. So in the last lesson we learned when to use passive voice and when not to use passive voice. Today we will be looking at some more set of rules we have to use when we are converting an active voice into passive voice. So there are certain things that you have to keep in mind while trying to convert an active voice into passive voice. So the first thing is that all active sentences cannot be turned into the passive form. So we looked at this in the last class as well. There are certain verbs which are intransitive. So intransitive verbs do not take an object, and such sentences sentences with intransitive verbs cannot be turned into a passive form. So let's look at some examples. So you have try this along with me. See if you can identify which sentences cannot be converted into the passive form. So the first sentence, I bought a book. Now bought here is a transitive verb. Why? Because we have the object a book. So when it is a transitive verb, you can convert it into passive. So the answer is yes, and the passive form is a book was bought by me. Let's look at another sentence. He laughs. Do we have an object here? No, laughs does not take an object. So laughs is an intransitive verb, so it cannot be converted into the passive form. They weighed the truck. You have an object there, the truck. So weighed is a transitive verb, and hence it can be converted into the passive voice. So it is, the truck was weighed. He died in 2005. Now, usually when you have something written after the verb, we tend to think of it as an object. But here, in 2005 is not the object. Died is an intransitive verb there. So it cannot be converted into the passive form either. Finally, he was running too fast. Again, too fast is not an object. So it cannot be converted into the passive form either. The second thing to keep in mind is that the verb in the passive sentence is always in the past participle. So sometimes with most of the verbs you can add an ed and make it into the past participle. So for instance, with the verb open, you can add ed to open and it would be opened, and that is the past participle form. But this is not the case always. So in chain it is chained, but in break you cannot add ed to the end of break. The past participle is not break, but it is broken. So there are verbs where you cannot add an ed and make the past participle. So there are irregular verbs as well, and you have to be very careful when you convert a verb into the past participle form. You do not just add an ed and think that you will get the past participle always. Let's look at some more examples. Come, the past participle of come is again come. You do not have ed or any other form, it's just come. So, and then you have fly, the past participle is flown. And then you have give, the past participle is given. So in the passive construction, you put the object first, and then you have the be form, and then you have past participle of the verb, and then you have a subject. So let's look at one sentence. The bottle was broken by him. Broken here is in the past participle form. The book was given to her. So given is again in the past participle form. The next thing to keep in mind is that the subject and the verb must always agree in number. So let's look at an active sentence here. The doctor treats the patient. Now in an active voice sentence, the doctor is the subject, verb is treats, and object is the patient. Now when you convert it into the passive form, the object here becomes the subject. So it would be, the patient is treated by the doctor. Now the patient is the subject in the new passive voice construction, and this has to agree with whether the patient is singular or plural should be reflected in the verb also. So because patient here is singular, we have used is. So if it was, say, The doctor treats the patients. The patients here is plural. So in such a situation, we would have used are instead of is. So this is what I meant by the subject and the verb must always agree in number. If the subject is singular, then the verb should be singular. And when the subject is plural, the verb should be plural. But also keep in mind, you should not confuse the subject of the active voice with the subject of the passive voice. So when I say that in the passive construction, we have the subject and the verb must agree, I am talking about the object of the sentence in the active voice, which would be the subject in the passive voice. So now let's look at passive voice construction according to tense forms. So today we would be looking at just five different kinds of tense forms. So the first one is simple present. This is the easiest one. And so let's look at some examples for it. So active voice, you have Gaurav speaks English. So in the present tense, simple present tense, the verb, you usually have the base form of the verb, and if it's a third person such as he or she etc., then you have third person singular, you have to add an s to the base form. So here you have Gaurav, which is in the third person form, so you add speak and an s to the speak verb. So how do you make it into passive? So the object comes first, and then you have is, and then you have spoken by Gaurav. So spoken is the past participle form, and you have added an is to the past participle in order to convert it into passive. Ritu sings Hindi songs. Now Hindi songs is in plural. We looked at that in the previous example. So Hindi songs being plural, the verb should also be plural. So Hindi songs are sung by Ritu. Benji does not speak English. Benji doesn't speak English. Now this, you have a negative form here. So does and followed by not and speak English. So how do you make a negative sentence into passive? So the object remains the same, English, and then you have is, and then you have not, and then you put the past participle construction followed by the doer, by Benji. So the rule is object, and then you have the be form, and then you have not, and then you have the past participle followed by and the subject. Ram does not write letters. Letters are not written by Ram. My doctor treats me. So here the object is me. Remember, when you convert me into the passive form, it becomes I. So when me comes to the first position, it would be I, and with an I, the be form is am. So I am treated by my doctor. So the rule for the simple present form is or am or are plus past participle of the verb. Now let's look at the second tense form, which is present continuous. So a present continuous of any verb is composed of two parts: the present tense of the verb to be and the present participle of the main verb. That would be the ing form of the main verb. So she is making tea. Is the be form, and ing form of make is making. So this is a present continuous tense. And how do you convert a present continuous into a present continuous active voice to a passive voice? The tea is being made by her. Raju is milking the cows. So it would be the cows are being milked by Raju. Another example, my mom is scolding me. I, remember, when me becomes in the passive form, it becomes I am being scolded by my mom. Sunil is not making dinner. So dinner is not being made by Sunil. So this is a negative construction. So Sunil is not. So is not making dinner is the active voice. So when you convert it into passive, it should be the object. After that, you have the be form, and then you have the not, and then you have being, and then you have the past participle of the verb, and after that by the doer. So dinner is not being made by Sunil. So the rule is or am or are plus being plus past participle. And if it is a negative construction, is or am or are followed by not plus being plus past participle. Let's look at the next form, that is present perfect. So the present perfect of any verb is composed of two elements. The appropriate form of the auxiliary verb, that is auxiliary verb have, which would be in the present tense, it would be either has or have. And then you have the past participle of the main verb. She has made tea. So this is a present perfect sentence in active form. So in the passive form, it becomes tea has been made by her. Another example, Raju has milked the cows. The cows have been milked by Raju. My mom has scolded me. I have been scolded by my mom. Sunil has not made dinner. Again, a negative construction. So, dinner has not been made by Sunil. As you can see, it is object plus after that you have has, and then if you have a negative construction, not, and then been, and after that you have the past participle. So the rule is, in the case of present perfect, when you convert it into passive, it has to be have or has plus been, and then you have the past participle of the verb. Next one is simple past. In the simple past, a simple past is used to talk about a completed action that has happened in a time before now. So the simple past is the basic form of past tense in English. And let's look at this sentence here. She made tea. So tea was made by her. Raju milked the cows. The cows were milked by Raju. My mom scolded me. I was scolded by my mom. Sunil did not make dinner. Dinner was not made by Sunil. So the rule is, in a simple past active voice sentence, if you are to convert it into passive voice, you have to add was or were plus past participle. And in the case of a negative, such as Sunil did not make dinner, you will put was or were plus not plus the past participle. Next is past continuous. So the past continuous of a verb has again two parts. The past tense of the verb to be, which would be was or were, and the base of the main verb in the ing form. So she was making tea. This would be tea was being made by her. Raju was milking the cows. This would be the cows were being milked by Raju. My mom was scolding me. I was being scolded by my mom. Sunil was not making dinner. Dinner was not being made by Sunil. Here is was or were plus being plus past participle. So if the active voice in past continuous, remember, depending on whether the subject is singular or plural, you have was or were and then being plus past participle. Next one is past perfect. So this is the last tense we'll be looking at today. So in the past perfect, you have the past perfect is composed of two parts, the past tense of the verb to to have, which would be had, and then the past participle of the main verb. So this example here, you have had and made. This is the past perfect tense of make. So in the past perfect case, when you convert it into passive, it becomes tea had been made by her. Raju had milked the cows, had milked. So when you make it into the passive, the cows had been milked by Raju. Active voice next one, my mom had scolded me. It would be I had been scolded by my mom. Sunil had not made dinner. Dinner had not been made by Sunil. So the rule is very simple. Had been plus past participle. That would be the passive construction for the past perfect. So that's it for today's lesson. In the next lesson, we would be looking at how slightly more complex sentences, how to convert questions and imperatives into the passive form as well. And we'll also look at certain tense forms which cannot be converted into the passive voice. So thank you, everyone.